healthy body has a sound mind. So if you don't have a peaceful mind, you cannot do devotion nicely. So good health helps. In fact, Srimad Bhagavatam, Narad Muni says that there's a famous shloka, Kamasya Naindri Priti Labo Jivyatayavata Jivasya Tattva Chikyata Jigyasa. That verse Narad Muni says in Bhagavatam, first canto, that that one should desire preservation of life. One should desire a healthy life. Not for sense gratification, but for inquiry into absolute truth. So, health is important, and in fact, there's some disturbance here. I think there's a moisture probably. So, Sri Srila Prabhupada actually, he was also very specific about his health. He used to take massages, he used to carry his Ayurvedic medicines everywhere. He used to have a discipline. And he used to have a special diet, also because of his old age and traveling, but he used to have and special cook. And he also used to, his most of his letters, if you read his letters, many of his letters, he ended his letters by one line. No. Hoping this meets you in good health. So that's important. So, but the question is, in spite of all these things, devotees are very sick. Most of the devotees whom I meet, especially brahmacharis, either back problems, stomach problem, all problems. It's a big problem. And people are struggling with their bodies and health, they're disturbed, and they can't do devotion properly. But on the other hand, Krishna gives a clue in Bhagavad Gita how to be healthy. Krishna speaks everything in Bhagavad Gita. And there's a first verse in 6th chapter. You know which verse? Yuktahar vihara sacha. Yukta cheshta sakarma sau. Then? Yukta sapna avodasya yoga bhakti dukkha. So Krishna says anybody who is disciplined, Prabhupada translates, one who is disciplined in eating, in habits of eating, sleeping, and exercises. By practice of yoga, he can be free from all miseries. Not exactly, but almost like this. So, Krishna gives a hint, and this is precisely Ayurveda. Ayurveda is not medicines. Just like allopathy. Allopathy is medicines. That's all. In allopathy, we have SPM, but he knows, you know. In India, we have SPM, social preventive medicine. It's something they tell, but it's all crap. It's nothing. But Ayurveda, unfortunately, most of the doctors who practice, they don't practice prevention or precaution. They practice medicines. In America, herbs and all these things are famous. Any patient who comes, they give medicine. But Ayurveda doesn't recommend that. Ayurveda says you can be healthy just by controlling three things. Or Krishna says, diet, sleep, exercise. And third thing is celibacy. Brahmacharya. Three things. Diet includes exercise. Now, that's one thing. So, these are very broad topics. Diet, sleep, ahar, nidra and brahmacharya. These are called three upastambas, three pillars of health. And then Ayurveda gives rules of these three. But one thing you have to make sure, if you want to be healthy, you can't just regulate your diet and be unregulated in sleep and other rules and regulations and you can expect health. No. This is a package. This is a package. So celibacy doesn't necessarily means, brahmacharya doesn't mean only celibacy. Brahmacharya means rules, general rules of walking, you know, and sitting and communicating, and also plus rules for interaction with people, which helps you to keep your mind controlled. So celibacy is that. For example, you should know how much to interact with this material world. If you interact in a wrong way, your mind will be disturbed, and then you will not be able to control your mind, and then that is a brahmacharya, you see. So celibacy is a very broad term. It's not just a very, very narrow term. Celibacy means, okay, no sex outside marriage, for example. No, it's not like that. It's like no seeing, no watching, no bad, wrong things, for example. You understand? Seeing, hearing, to be controlled. So these three things, you have to do all three of these things. So for example, people, first of all, people don't know how to control their diet. Second of all, even if they control their diet, their sleeping pattern is messed up. And they have no idea how to interact with this material world. So they become unhealthy. They end up having problems, and then they say, well, my eating habits, I was having balanced diet or this. Nothing happens. So all these three have to be controlled. Now, there are rules for this. You have to follow those rules. But before following those rules, you have to understand some principles. Otherwise, you will be following, but you don't know why you're doing that. And you will also not be able to follow that if you don't understand these principles of Ayurveda. Now, these principles, I'll tell you in a few minutes. But before that, let me tell you that these principles are very scientific and very mathematical. And to follow these principles, it's not difficult. It's easy to understand these principles, but you have to tune yourself with nature. Otherwise, you will not be able to understand this. This is a different science. This is a holistic science. It's not, you do this, you do this. It's not like that. So, we have, most of us are disconnected with nature, no? You see, you're disconnected. You're inside your room, always. You have no idea what's going outside. So, then it becomes difficult to follow the rules of Ayurveda. You can follow something, but if you want to really follow rules, then you have to be out and know what's happening in the universe, because your body is connected with the universe. This is the first principle of Ayurveda. Yatha annam, tatha pindam. You know this? You have heard this? So whatever happens in the universe, that is happening in a body. So for example, if you go out now, now you have to see what's happening outside. So if outside there's moisture, and it's wet, damp, it's like that, no? So your body is also like that. It's wet and damp from inside. There's a lot of moisture in your body. Although you're staying in AC, that doesn't matter. Because it is, well, entanglement, you can say. Your body is entangled with this universe. So, having said this, you have to understand three things. Science of temperature. These are some sciences you have to understand. It's easy, but you have to get a hang of it. And that I will explain how. Science of temperature, science of time, how time moves, and how time changes with every hour, every 3 hourly, every quarterly. Time changes. Every time is different. So 6 to 7 in the morning is different from 6 to 7 in the evening. But you have to know how they are different. In fact, many people have cured their cancer by understanding science of time. And you can do that, not by medicine, just by understanding how time moves. So science of time, science of temperature, and then science of movement. How your movement of body affects your mind. So once you understand this, then you can go with nature. And once you go along with nature, nature will support you. And you'll become healthy. But now what is happening is, we are trying everything, but we are going against nature, against the current. So how can you be healthy? Nature is doing something. You are doing something else. And you are ending up becoming unhealthy. Then you are taking some medicines to adjust. Wo jugaad nahi kehte usko. You understand, na? You know jugaad is jugaad. You know. So wo something you do, something, but come on, if there is a cyclone, you will not be able to help yourself. Whole nature is against you. So for example, if you sleep after 10:30, you will not get good sleep. 100%. Because you're working against the nature. Whole nature, whole universe goes to sleep at that time. Everything shuts down. 10:30, 10:45. But you are awake. Now you are awake at that time and whole universe is trying to shut down. Your body is trying to shut down and you're trying to wake it up by something. So you'll end up in disease, that's all, finish. Definitely. How can you not end up in disease? So except if you have practice to get up in the night. That's one thing. If you have some duty, night duties. If you have practiced, that's other thing. But even if you have practiced, long term bad practice will also lead to bad results. You can't just say I'm practiced and you can say do whole life. You can't do that. So these sciences I'll just tell you in few minutes. But before that I'll tell you some rules of Ayurveda, which everyone must follow, which you can follow from now. Even without understanding, you can do that. So understanding can come later, no problem. So first thing is diet. So in diet, what you do? First rule is in eating is I told you, don't eat between 10:30 to 2:30. Don't eat anything. So that's said in Vishnu Smriti. Madhyanam na bhojanam. You should not eat in madhyanam. Madhyan means 10:30 to 3:30 exactly.
You mean morning?
Afternoon. Okay. 10:30 to 3:30. But 3:30 is the extreme limit. You can go back till 2:30. Then back at 10:30 to 2:30, never eat. You're feeling tired?
No, a little bit.
Yeah. You can wash your face and otherwise. So don't eat between 10:30 to 2:30. That's very important. That's the first rule. If you eat, you become sick. At that time, whatever you eat, it will become to ash. It will not go to your body. And why thing is different. Why thing? I'll tell you in between, just after a second. Then other rules in eating is, don't eat in the night. That's one thing. Especially, don't eat in night. In night also from 10:30 to 2:30 you should not eat. At that time you should be sleeping. That's another rule. From 10:30 to 2:30 you should be sleeping. So don't sleep after 10:30. Don't eat after 10:30 in night and in afternoon. Both, that bracket.
No sleep in night.
No. You should always sleep from 10:30 to 2:30 in the night. And you should never sleep from 10:30 to 2:30 in the afternoon. Mm. It's a daytime, no? Mm. But eating should not be there, both.
Mm.
Eating should never be there. So, if you feel hungry sometimes, then you can eat one apple. Maybe some juice you can drink. That's all. That's very important. And no sleeping between 10:30 to 2:30 in the morning. In daytime. Never sleep. If you sleep at that time, definitely you're going to become ill. Sick.
Any age?
See, for children below 14 years, it's not strict. But above 14 years, then, because children below 14 years, they're very active, naughty, playing and doing so many things, no? So it's not that strict for children, but for adults after 14 years, you have to follow all these things. And then what else in diet? Actually, can you bring my computer? That big one. So, don't drink water with food. That's very important. You can drink water before food, but not while eating or after. And don't drink any juice with food. You were drinking juice?
No, not with food.
Just after
before,
food.
Before food.
Before, yeah. Yeah, yes, thank you.
So, left over, that's
fine. I just remembered, I just saw you. So anyway, you don't know. So don't drink juice, because if you drink juice, then you, whatever you eat, your fire is there and you're putting water, you know. So it just goes off. It's just very unscientific. So no digestion. So don't drink juice. There's a rule of eating. You have to be systematic. So if you eat cold and hot together, food, you have to see what is cold, what is hot. So first eat cold and then eat hot. Because if you first eat hot and then eat cold, then you finish the fire. See, everything is fire in the stomach. This controls. So because of fire in the stomach, you have glow on your face. It's good intelligence, good health. You know, good fire means good health. That's why you go to any Ayurveda doctor, first they will ask digestion, no? They will try to make your digestion proper. So that's why people do exercises. Exercises helps us to improve our fire. Especially yoga. And some kind of exercise, running or whatever, walking. It maintains your fire in the body. So that is one other rule. Okay, let me just tell you some rules now. Health and all that. You can also keep some questions in your mind if you have.
Questions.
Because
Prabhu, regarding skills.
I will just
Can you ask how it is in the mind?
Yeah, I'll just tell you, yeah. You can ask me.
Let me ask you.
What are you asking?
You said 10:30 to 2:30 in the morning you should not sleep, right? But with the kids, if we don't have enough sleep in the night, it's like a disturbed sleep cause. So usually in the morning, after everything work is done, I feel like a tired, right? Sometimes.
Well,
what should we
do? Everybody feels tired at that time. Everybody.
Because then in the night, I don't have enough sleep.
That's one thing. If night you can't sleep properly, then it is advised that you should sleep in the daytime, but not at that time.
So when should the sleep?
Before 10:30.
Okay.
After 2:30.
Okay.
You have to manage like that. Otherwise you become sick. Laws of nature will not ask you what you are doing. They lack. At that time, sleep, no. If you sleep, your life will reduce. Your life will reduce. Not that you become disease. Your life, it will become short span. So you have to be, that's the most important thing. All Dharma Shastras, Ayurveda, all scriptures even say, Bible says, don't sleep in daytime. It's not 10:30 to 2:30, it's daytime.
Yeah.
You should not sleep in day.
But
that bracket, if you cannot sleep in day, then bracket you should never sleep. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
After that you can somehow adjust and sleep, but not at a time. Okay, eat while facing north or east. A direction is important. You should not eat while west and south. So you have to see in what direction. That matters. If you sit in wrong direction, you'll become sick.
Mm-hmm.
I've experienced.
So which direction?
North or east?
Should face
towards north.
Oh.
This is east, no?
Yeah.
No, this is east.
Okay, so this is north.
East, no.
North or this side?
These two directions, okay.
Yeah. You should not eat in any direction. Direction matters because, you see, you will not come to know because we come to know because we are practicing. But when you start practicing, you'll come to know these things have effect. Because even science says Earth has magnetic field, no? So our body is linked, our body also have electromagnetic fields, no? There's cell and there's neutrons, everything is going on, so it affects our body. And wash your mouth and feet after eating.
Feet also? Feet.
Yeah, before eating and after eating, both. Actually, ideally you should wash your hand. You see Muslims, they wash, no?
Yeah.
Baju, baju, baju. They say baju. So even before namaz. It's same, it's scripture, same thing it said. You should wash till here, then till knees, then your eyes, then your senses. Senses should be washed with water. Eyes, nose, mouth, ears. So you will feel fresh. You try sometimes, you will feel so fresh. Then your digestion is very good. And you can really focus on what you are eating. Otherwise you will be eating like animals. Chalo, we plate lao, khach 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 khatam. Then you don't know what you're eating, why you're eating. So then food doesn't actually help you. We are not even respecting prasad in that way. See, traditionally people used to wash their feet. No, you have seen, even in South India still they wash.
Yes.
If you don't wash, no, they will say, what crap, this is like crazy person. They'll not respect you. So you have to wash your mouth and feet after mouth, feet and hands. After eating and before eating. That's a rule. Also, while eating, it's good to sit on floor. This dining table system is... it's completely crazy. It's not good for health.
Yeah, the dining floor is easy to feather.
Actually, you know what? Floor first is easy, direction is okay, but... another thing is, if you sit on dining table and eat on chair,
you eat more. You eat more.
Yeah, first you end up eating more because you're sitting like this down. Second thing is, there are high chances of cancer. It is now science. I was reading an article in British Medical Journal and they did some research because you're not straight. Your colon is not straight when you're sitting that in that position, no. Even when you go on Western toilet, it's not straight. So you don't end up, first of all, so digestion is not proper. It's cross-legged. And another thing is, if you sit on chair, body is confused. You're not standing, you're not sitting. You are half. So body doesn't know whether you want to stand, walk, go somewhere, or you want to sit. So because of that, what happens is, body doesn't produce appropriate enzymes and hormones, and it is not prepared to eat. This mind is confused, no? And on the top, you are wearing your shoes. Body, come on, you know, you want to go somewhere? So, there is no proper signal. If you sit, body knows, okay. He is at one place. And he wants to do something. That is why when you study, you should sit down and study. It's good to sit on floor. So it improves your memory. If you sit on table, no table chair, it will not help you much. So that's one thing. If possible, sit down. Sit down. Don't sit on sofas. Never sit on sofa and eat. You sit on sofa and eat, definitely you are bringing bad health for yourself. Sofa, you are like, no shape, no. You are like, you are just into that. So, you know what, if you don't sit properly, your energies are not flowing properly in your body. It's not just intestine positions, it's some flow of energy, no? That has to be proper. So, our energy is flowing in our channels, in our body. What happened?
College.
Children? Just, what they're doing? Just forget it. Children,
Gopisha likes this.
She likes, okay, then call her. Okay, if you want to come back, but let them not. Kids are nuisance. America is okay. They are okay. They are okay, kids. In India, they are like.
Gopisha likes to know this kind of thing. Achcha.
Okay, call her.
Then she'll remind us, hey, come on, sit on the floor.
Okay, then go fish.
Listen to this and remind us.
Okay, you want to hear about health.
It's about health.
Okay, so the point is, if you don't sit properly, your energies are not flowing properly. And if energy is not flowing properly, then your food doesn't get digested, nothing happens. So it is not, Ayurveda is subtle, it's not just gross. So we have no idea in allopathy of all these things. We have no idea. So don't sit on sofas and eat. Don't sit on dining table and eat. Avoid it, if possible. Sit on floor. In America, you can sit on floor. America, no problem. I've seen students sitting in universities on floor. In India, they are very, very Americanized. America, it's all free. So just sit on floor. Try to do that. It'll help you. And even reading, sit on floor. That's good. And after eating, you should walk for some time. But there's a rule. You should only walk 72 steps. That's all. You know what? When Krishna in Vrindavan, he eats in his dining room. And from his dining room, his restroom is not bedroom. His bedroom is just 72 steps. So he takes lunch, then he walks 72 steps, and then goes and takes a rest. It's very scientific. 72 steps. So walk. So some people keep on walking, no? Like after dinner, they go for a long walk. Not more than 72 steps. 72 steps will be how much? How many meters? How many? We have to see how much it will be. One step is how much? 1 feet? 2 feet?
2 feet.
2 feet, no? Yeah. It will be like that. The 72 steps will be 144 feet. This is how many meters? We don't know.
Yes.
Maybe like 1 block.
I think 1 block.
144
meter. Anyway.
I'm going to convert to centimeter.
Centimeter. By 12.
Yeah, by 12.
Yeah.
By 100.
So approximately 100. What about this? Just do that. So okay, fine. So don't walk. Don't go for a long walk. Something and take it. Rest, that's all, finish. Until unless you're feeling heavy or whatever, then you can walk a little. Never take water after eating. Try eating with hand, not with spoon. Because if you eat with spoon, then your digestion begins in mouth. But if you eat with hand, your digestion begins with hand.
Oh.
Yeah, as soon as you touch the food, digestion begins. Because your hand can sense, whether it is soft. It can sense the softness or hardness, temperature, dryness and liquidness, everything. So body prepares. By the time you bring food, body is prepared. But if you eat with spoon, body is not prepared. You immediately put and there's a shock. Food! But body is not prepared. And you gulp inside. Finish. So no digestion. That is why people used to eat by hand, no? Previously. Everybody. Spoon is a British culture, no? Spoon is not good culture. Avoid spoons. Eat with hand. And of course, this is a system by eating hand. You can't eat like, some people eat like wild, like South India. Like crazy. You can eat properly, but you should eat with hand. But for that, your nails should be cut. Except females. It's a different story. Females, that's okay, but generally, it should be clean. Otherwise, you'll end up having trouble. So, avoid eating at night time. No curd at night. Never eat curd at night.
No curd rice?
Eating curd at night is equal to cow meat.
Wow.
That's all.
What can you repeat? What did you
say? Eating curd at night is equal to eating cow.
Oh.
That same sin you will get. It's in scriptures.
So night is after 7 p.m.
Night is after dusk. Dusk, dawn and dusk. After dusk, it's night. You can't eat curd.
What about the butterfly? same.
Buttermilk night we don't take. Buttermilk never night. You'll end up having cold and so curd has to be taken in morning, and also you have to take curd with sugar or amla or dal, any of the three. If you don't take curd with this, then it'll act as a poison.
So no plain, no with salt.
No plain, never no with salt.
Oh, okay.
So salt?
No, sugar.
No salt.
Sugar,
amla, or dal. Yeah. It's like khichdi we take, no?
Yes.
So usme, they have dal, yeah. Or put amla.
So can we
kadi? Kadi is also khatta, no?
But it's with the chickpea flour, so it's okay.
No, but it's khatta. That's okay. Mm-hmm. They're dal, no?
Yeah,
pulse.
So, bro, plain khichdi, plain dahi.
Plain curd we don't take.
No, plain curd in khichdi mix.
Yeah, yeah, so you take with dal.
There is, okay, perfect.
Or sugar.
Okay.
Yeah, that's bad. It'll help. Curd is very, very, very tricky thing.
Srikhand?
Srikhand is with sugar, no?
Srikhand and dal.
And then, these are some rules, general rules I'm telling you. No olive oil. Don't take olive oil, don't take sunflower oil, don't take safflower oil. These are all for animals. Don't take, throw it in your drain.
Peanut oil?
Take four oils, any of the four oils. Coconut, peanut, mustard or sesame. Sesame oil. But that's all.
That's good, Prabhu?
That's good.
Coconut, sesame, peanut.
That is for humans. Good, I don't
know. What are the other things? You said four, right, Prabhu?
Huh?
Coconut, sesame, peanut,
or
mustard.
Mustard oil. So north they use mustard. North Bengal mustard oil. South India coconut. And then groundnut oil. Gujarat, Rajasthan area they use groundnut oil.
And that's what we get. Right?
Here you get groundnut oil.
Yeah. I mean, after you told us 2 years ago, we stopped. We get peanut oil from Sam's.
Okay. Good. Mm-hmm. Well, I gave a seminar on health at your place. Nothing. I just told something.
Yeah. We used to get all the vegetable oil.
That's very bad.
Then we stopped. Food also like tasted very nice.
So groundnut peanut is
peanut.
Right?
You get big container and salt.
Yes.
So don't mix salt with milk items.
Mm-hmm.
Don't take milk with food because there's salt in food. So milk has to be taken not with food. Ideally, milk preparations you can take, but not milk. Preparations you can always take because that's not milk, that is milk preparation, so its whole constitution changes. Raw milk don't take with food, and also take less of carrots. Carrot halwa you made, I didn't take much. Yeah, less carrots, less brinjal, sweet potato. And heavy pulses. These four things you should take less.
What is the last one?
Heavy pulses. Like odad dal.
Oh, okay.
Odad dal. Heavy pulse.
Rajma.
Rajma, odad dal.
Soya.
Chana dal.
Soya, throw it. That's all. Soya you should not eat. America, they are crazy after soya.
Tofu?
That's all. No. See, soya is a wild plant. It's according to Ayurveda. And that is for wild people. Not for civilized human being. It's not there. No recipe is given in Ayurveda for soya. In India, nobody knew soya, no? Abhi to aaya hai, abhi to. Pata nahi, abhi yahan se. The soya, you should just avoid it. Soya is... I couldn't find evidence, but I read in Kashyap Samhita. Long, many years back, I'm trying to find that evidence. Kashyap Muni says soya causes liver failure and kidney failure. So you should avoid soya. Just avoid soya. So, but carrots, that is avoid. But less of carrots, brinjal, sweet potato, and heavy pulses, all this rajma, chola. Don't take it, it's heavy for system.
Chole.
Less, yeah. Not all. Like Like in Haryana, they always take rajma, heavy diet. Punjab also, they do all those things. Don't take much. If any, like, see, scorn if you have feast, you know. You have, like, okay, matar paneer, chola, and what is this, you know. So you end up having, if you have, and scorn especially, every day is a, some kind of party, you know, some hair party, that, and you end up eating such kind of stuff, you know. Then you become sick. Every day pastries, every day cakes and this and that. And ISKCON devotees are very sick. They are more sick than ordinary people. More. ISKCON culture is like that, no? It's a kitchen culture, no? Prabhupada says. So you end up having sickness. And then, okay, you have to make very nice things for Krishna, and then you make for him and then eat yourself. He can digest, but you can't do. He can do that.
What do we do with that?
Make little. Don't make much. Make little. And then distribute. That's all. Or make very little. Take little, little. Like, if you want to make something for Krishna, don't make this much. And then eat everything. That's, first of all, that's not devotionally correct. Prabhupada said in Act of Instruction, give nice things to Krishna, for yourself eat simple things. It's because otherwise, if you keep on eating, you will get involved in all sense gratification. So make something little, and then distribute. That's all. Give to kids can digest, so little bit they can eat. Okay, so yeah, carrots also very not good. It makes your blood thin, so it's not good for health much. Brinjal not much because yeah, sweet food at home.
Eggplant.
Okay, cold drinks. Don't take cold drinks. Avoid it. Cold drinks.
It'll is cold water also?
No, cold drinks. All this?
Soda.
Anyway, devotees, first of all, should not take lemonade and Coca-Cola and all this. You should not eat. Because anyway, they have a lot of chemicals, no? Artificial color, preservatives. You'll end up having cancer. It's just avoid that. And on the top of that, cold drinks will cause your digestion to go down. Fire. And you'll end up getting unhealthy. So don't take much cold drinks. Don't take canned food if possible. In America, use canned food, na everything? I don't know if you can avoid it, it's good. Because canned food is in mode of ignorance. It's canned, no? So it's in tamogun. Your mind will go into mode of ignorance. You might not feel that. You might feel, okay, I am active. But no, see, the point is, in mode of ignorance, you will not be able to understand subtle things about nature. Once you get out of it, then you will understand you were in mode of ignorance. So if you eat canned food, avoid it. If you can avoid, just avoid it. And many devotees do, they get fresh stuff from market. Hota hai, aap hai, market lagti hai na?
Yeah. Only we use is canned tomatoes. Otherwise, nothing canned.
Why canned tomatoes? It's fresh. Use fresh tomato. You can't use that.
It's easier.
Yeah.
And cheaper.
It's paste made and everything in the skin.
Some mehnat.
You have to find out how.
Just see. If you try to adjust, things will get adjusted. But it will help you in very long term. It will help you a lot.
So, tomatoes,
yeah. Tomatoes, nothing. Tomatoes you can eat. Some people say,
shade.
Yeah, Indian tomato and all those things. But, kya shade kya?
Shades,
kuch kehte. But no, bas, you can eat tomato, that's okay. Okay, always take cooked food, raw food don't take. In America, there's a lot of raw food. Salad you can take little. But some people take raw food, raw diet. That's the worst thing you can do in your life. Ayurveda says everything should be cooked. Raw food is for animals. It's not for human body. So don't take raw food. Salad also, not much. Salad take less. Generally there's an advice, no, take a lot of salad. Roughage and all those things.
Make a meal out of
salad. That's very bad. Don't take raw food. Never do that. No matter how much you hear in America, this, that. Ayurveda says no. Absolutely no raw food. And take less water as much as you can, I told in the morning. Take less water, don't take much water.
Less water?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. More water will cause impotency. It will cause so many problems. You see, it's common sense. If you take food, suppose if you take food, and if you pick it in a can, and there's a moisture, just after 7-8 hours, what will happen? Fungus. Fungal infection. Fungus, no? But if you keep a dry thing, you take for traveling dry thing, nothing happens? Nothing. 3-4 days, nothing happens. Similarly, if your body has less water, your body is prone to less infections. It has more water, there's more infections. And this is from infection theory I'm talking, from modern angle. But from Ayurvedic angle, water increases kapha in your body. And kapha will produce inertia. This is some principles I'm talking. So, oh yeah, six things I have to tell you now.
So how much?
What is
the recommended?
Correct amount.
Correct amount?
Correct amount of water to take.
Every 5 days?
See, I drink water every 6-7 days, maybe after every 15 days, something. I don't drink water. Because you can get by food. Food, you take little dal, little, it suffices. If you practice, no water is required. And you are healthy.
Some people say in the
so yoga, you have to practice as much as huh?
Some people say in the yoga that before you, after you wake up in the morning, don't brush your teeth, drink at least 2 glasses of water.
Warm.
Then you go to warm water.
Yeah, yeah, some people say that.
Is that healthy or they still
no.
Saying no?
See, in Ayurveda it is said, keep water in the night, in a can, in a bouquet of brass.
Copper.
And then drink in the morning. You can do that, but practically I have seen people who do that, they get acidity. It is a problem. They practically get that. Our bodies are becoming weak now. So you can do that, but that's not necessary. It is not compulsory. In Ayurvedic, if you see the daily routine, Ritu Charya, it doesn't say that you have to get up and drink water. It's optional. But if you start taking water, then your body becomes accustomed to it. And you don't get, then you can't pass, you empty your stomach without water. You have to drink water. And then that becomes a problem.
Okay.
So better no water, that's all, finish. As soon as you get up, it should be natural. Your body naturally will be able to actually function. So slowly you have to reduce water. If you immediately reduce water, there will be a problem. Slowly reduce water. First you can do one thing, you can stop drinking water at night. Start with this. After dusk, don't take water. And slowly you read it after 3 o'clock in the afternoon, don't take water. You're reading in the morning. Slowly you can practice. Or drink less. But whenever you drink, suppose if you have thirst, you drink less. Don't just take bottle, cut. That's a very bad habit. Don't do that. In fact, it is said in Bengali, jal khawe. You have to eat water. So when you drink any liquid, first you have to put in mouth, and then if you do like this, there's a problem. Yeah. So take less water as much as you can. You'll be much healthy. That's all. More water, people are prone to kidney stones. I've seen people say, drink more water, you'll not get kidney stones. But I've seen people who drink more water, they are prone to kidney stones, because water also has these minerals, no? And then it goes.
In Dubai, because of drinking water, kidney stones form.
And you got?
Because of more drinking water in Dubai.
So, more water means you are prone to kidney stones. That's my practical experience. I don't know what. You're a child specialist. So, never overeat. One is that. So, overeating means. See, the point is overeating means, okay, for how much you should eat. That's a question, no? So you have, see, the rule is, when you eat, after you finish eating, you should feel hungry. That's the rule. Then you know you're not overeaten. After you finished eating, you should feel little hunger. And you get up. Don't allow your hunger to just finish. Keep hunger. Hunger is a friend. It's not an enemy. It becomes an enemy when it becomes too much. But in controlled way, limited way, it's a friend. Because if you have hunger in your body whole throughout the day, that you know what hunger will do? It will eat diseases in your body. So if you will never get cancer, never in your life, because it will eat all the bad things, that hunger. So that you have to practice. So you have to be conscious while eating. That is why it is said, don't talk while eating. No, you have to be conscious. If you keep on talking, seeing TV, then you don't know what you are doing.
Books.
No, just stop everything. You have to see what your body is doing at that time. You're putting something in your body. It's a very serious issue, no? It's not a small issue. You're putting something in your body. Some foreign thing. Although it's prasad, but you're putting something. So you have to see what's happening in your body. In fact, Ayurveda says you don't need any rules. You don't need any rules. Simply if you can observe what's happening in your body by interacting with this environment, you'll be able to figure out rules yourself. But we are not conscious, no? We are like, in modern age, we are so involved in so many things. Phone karte hai, cut, khaane hai. So, kya hoga? You will not be able to understand anything. We are not even, what to say of Krishna consciousness? We are not even conscious of our bodies. What's happening there? So, you know, we can't be healthy. How will you be healthy? So, that's the first rule. That is why Dharma Shastra says, to talk while eating is a sin. They make it a sin. You see the point? Huh? Ropa never used to eat. We talk and many sannyasis, they don't talk. They don't talk. Sometimes talking is okay. Just like now, when you are there, devotees are there, you are together, you can talk, no problem. It should not be a routine habit.
I am saying talking should be light, the discussion should be light and it shouldn't be intense or heavy meetings.
Wo to hai, heavy meetings or wo to, your mind will be in. That's another thing. So, yeah, never overeat. So now you know the rule now. See, generally the rule is your stomach should be half empty, one-fourth with air. They say like that, no? Two-thirds should be empty, one-third should be water and one-third food. Yeah. But that's not practical. How do you know? Like you can't, you know, don't put an ultrasound there and see. So the practical guidance Ayurveda gives, keep hunger.
More and more, like you feel like a gas is forming inside.
Little hunger. After you eat and get up, you should feel, I can eat more. Mm-hmm. That feeling should be there, I can eat more. Okay. It is very less hunger. Okay. So don't take. See, you know, when you keep on eating, you practice. When you keep on eating, at one point your body says, okay, no. But then you still keep on eating.
We just go back.
But you just stop. Yeah, more mercy. So stop there. So that time, okay, then after you get up, then you can take more, but you don't want more. You will not take. So that's how you know.
So this keep hunger means
no, little.
Don't eat that.
No. Little bit hungry. Little bit hunger is there. Okay, do not exercise. So, diet is linked with exercise. Because...
One at a time you didn't cover. Cheese.
Cheese you should never take. Don't take cheese. Your pizza and all those. There's cheese, no? Cheese, no? Pizza means cheese, no? Cheese they put, no? Pizza?
Yeah.
Don't take cheese. Cheese is the worst thing you can eat in your life. It's very bad. It's all sadi cheese, na?
Sadi.
They keep a thing and then they ferment and it's all home bhi though you have to keep and sadana
so
padega.
Paneer.
Paneer you can use.
The cheese you can.
Yeah, if in home you have to make pizza, take pizza base, put paneer. With paneer you make.
Okay,
no problem. But don't take cheese. That's all. Cheese is Gandhi cheese, that's all. That's all you have. It's bad. You see the point, cheese is sticky, no?
Yeah.
So, pakadoge na. So you can know. See the point. See, our body is like a hollow tube, intestine. Now if you put, you can imagine, it's very easy Ayurveda. You imagine a tube and put a cheese in that. It will stick, no? Similarly, it will stick in your stomach. It will stick everywhere. Once it stick, and then it will ferment more. And it will produce gases, toxins, and you will end up having unhealthy. So that's how you have to imagine. Your body is like a tube, a can. So you touch and you imagine you're putting, and then what happens? Same thing will happen in your body. Simple. As simple as that. So diet is related to exercises. Because if you don't exercise, the food which goes in your body, it will block your channels. The subtle channels, food digests. You don't know, there's something called as chyle. You know chyle.
What?
Chyle. Chyle. That lymphatic channels are there, no? So they are chyle flows. So, in other words, food changes, and it goes into subtle channels. And if you don't do exercises, those subtle channels are blocked. Your muscles are stiff. Your muscles are stiff, channels are blocked. Small channels, and then food cannot go. So you don't get energy. Second, then food gets clogged somewhere and it gets toxin. So you have to do exercise, you have to open those channels. Otherwise, you will not get nourishment, you will end up having toxins, and all health problems will come. So diet goes with exercises. So if you take food, no exercise, there's no point of taking food. If you do exercise and no food, then anyway, there's no point, you'll become weak. So both are together. So exercise, something is required. But then there's a system to do exercise. Do not do exercise in noon time. From 10:30 to 2:30, do not do exercise, same thing. Or in evenings. In America, they keep on running, no? In evening. Anytime they'll do exercise.
Yeah, now in office they started lunchtime exercise.
Yeah, they don't have any concept of time. Because if you do in lunchtime, what happens is afternoon it's time of pitta. It's heat in universe. Sun is there, no?
Yeah.
Heat. You do exercise, then you produce more heat. So if your car gets heated, what happens? Stops, no? So this is a machine. You first, it's heated by universe. You are in AC, but I told you it's linked with the universe. There's a heat. You do exercise and you make it more heat, then it stops. You end up in problems. So don't do exercises in afternoon, don't do in late evenings. There's just one slot you can do exercise. Two things, two slots. One is morning from 6 to 9. Don't do early morning.
5:30.
No. After sunrise. From 6, this is one slot, 6 to 9, or in the evening from 4 to 6, before dusk. Just two times, there no other time you can do exercise. That's all. So you have to figure out yourself how to do. So 20 minutes exercise is okay. See, there's a rule for exercise. Don't do exercises. Exercise, what is exercise? When you do exercise, your heart rate should increase a little bit. And you should have sweat on your forehead, and that's all. And there you should stop. But if you keep on doing exercise, you know, people now run and their shirt becomes wet and this, and then they put that machine, you know. It's all useless. You end up, that is excess of exercise. And that will produce, long term it will produce unhealthy. You know what? In America, there is a big syndrome, chronic fatigue syndrome. Yeah, there is, no? People are suffering chronic fatigue. Without doing anything, they will become fatigue. Without doing anything, I am feeling tired. No, it happens, no? That is due to excess of exercises. Gym. You go to gym. Gym is not good. Don't go. Do this little yoga exercises. That is much better than gym. Gym is weights and all those things. It's not for... Just it's bad for
him. 2 months ago in Hedgepar, 123-year-old IT guy, he died in the gym because of excess exercise.
Excess.
too much sweating. Big summer, 2 months ago.
Dehydration. So no, you are not to depend on machines. Depend on nature. Just keep away yourself from machines. Machines will not allow you to understand what's happening in your body. No. So you put this machine and then you, okay, I'll learn this much. Come on, you know, you don't have to ask this machine, you have to ask your body. That is why there's a rule in Ayurveda, listen to your body. Listen. Body will tell you everything, what you need. But you have to be conscious. So, and do not do exercises after food. After food anyway. After food you're not allowed to do exercises. It is best to do exercises empty stomach. That's the best thing. It is good to do exercise outside. Don't do inside your home. In America, you prefer doing inside your home. Actually, I wanted to do under the sky, but there's no. That's why I go to park. It's good to do exercises under the sky. You know what? Exercises helps you not only to take fresh air, but fresh space. Space is also one thing which you don't have a concept. So that's akash, bhumirapa, nalovayu, kham, space. So you need sky. So when you take, when under sky you take breath, you don't just take fresh air, you take prana. You know prana? Pranic forces you take from sky. So then that your consciousness and your health become, health is dependent on prana, it's not just fresh air. So it's very important to do in outside. If you do inside, half of exercise is waste. So probably you may have to go to a park or maybe in your balcony, something. Do something, but do outside, it's important. You can do in America, you can do your big house. And actually, you know what, this, it's a very bad habit to always stay in the house. Don't do that. Go outside, sit outside. But people have big houses, but they don't use. No, no. I've seen in America, in Columbus, also Cincinnati. You buy a so costly house, so big park and everything, but you don't use. What's the point of that? It makes absolutely no sense. Sit outside in the balcony with your family, you know. Why do you want to sit in this closed windows and AC? It doesn't make any sense. In India, you don't have this privilege.
Yeah, and here we have nice parks.
You have privilege, but people don't use. So use that. Use that. Otherwise, it's very unhealthy lifestyle. Very unhealthy. So this is about food and exercises in summary. I'm not going in details. There are many things I have to tell you. But this is something. About sleep. Now sleep is important. You see, sleep is important. Nobody gives importance to sleep. But sleep is such a thing. In Ayurveda it says, if you don't know how to sleep and when to sleep, you'll be like a lion. You will be like a lion. You may be like a lion. Good diet, good energy, everything. But if your sleep is messed up, you will be like a lion pulling an elephant, trying to pull an elephant, taking to your cave to eat it. But in the process you die. You understand? You know what lion does? It kills an elephant, but it will not eat it on the road because it's king. Lion knows I'm a king. So it can't just eat anywhere. So it will want to take it to its own cave and eat it there, like a king, no? So it will try to pull it, but in the process it will become so tired. Lion is so high. And then it will die in between. So sleep is such a thing, if you mess up with sleep, no matter what you do, you'll end up unhealthy. 100%. Less sleep or more sleep? Sleeping at wrong time and sleeping in wrong posture. I'll tell you. So that's the most important thing which modern science have no idea. Sleep science is very, still very in a very retarded position now. We don't understand what sleep, first of all. Nobody knows. And how to sleep, who cares, you know, just sleep. That's all. They have some kind of health books, say some kind of things. When you sleep, your room should be, you know, like in a quiet place, very nice atmosphere, something they try to say, but they don't really understand what's happening. So, one rule is never sleep facing your head in north direction. Anybody who sleeps with his head towards north, this means he's calling death. That's all. Patani pehle, you know this? So, north direction, never face, put your head. You can put your head in any direction, but never north. So you have to see. You have to see. Yeah, don't put your head in that side. Okay, and sleeping in day, never. Especially 10:30 to 2:30. Don't sleep. Otherwise, and also scripture says you should not sleep in at daytime. That means sleeping is more than 40 minutes, it's sleeping. Actually more than 48 minutes. It's considered sleeping. So don't sleep maximum 48 minutes. Ideally, you should not sleep for more than 30 minutes. 30 to 40 minutes, okay.
So you can take naps.
Right? 40 minute nap, that's all. Not naps. Nap. That's nap.
Prabhupada says snap.
Yes, snap. Prabhupada says snap.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, snap. So like that, just to sleep. And also Ayurveda says that it's better to sleep while sitting in daytime. Because sitting and sleeping is no sleeping. If you're too tired, you can lie down, but then there's a chances of you'll be straight away getting up after 2 hours.
How is the body, like if you're sitting and eating food, how is the body know?
Sitting is nap.
So we should get rest.
No, no. So that is why, because it is not allowed for you to sleep in daytime.
That's why. Some concession.
So that is the concession, you sit and sleep. That's how it goes. But you can lie down. Then you ask somebody to wake you up, or you should have a habit. You can lie down, no problem. But there's a chances of sleeping more. That's the only problem. So that, what you have to do?
No, Baba, I have to go to make prasad for you.
Okay, I just finishing. I'll just finish. Just a moment. I always have to do many things. So, there's just a few minutes. So here, take a nap, preferably in the daytime. Preferably sitting. If you can't do that, lie down. But don't sleep more than 40 minutes.
But do we have to take nap?
Hmm?
We don't need to.
No, if you don't need, that's the best.
Okay. But who have backache problems?
So then lie down. But don't more than 40 minutes, don't do. You can lie down, but it's not necessary to sleep, no? What do you say to sleep? You can lie down, hear some lecture or something.
Yeah.
That's all. Why do you sleep? Some sleep is okay.
And one more thing, request, Prabhu, regarding. I'm sorry.
No, speak then.
Like you said, it's better to eat while sitting on the floor, right?
Mm.
So, some people will have. For me, I mean, I'm not.
Arthritis?
Regarding me, no, I have a backache problem.
See, exception is okay in general. If you can't sit on floor, okay. But you're sitting. But you're sitting now.
Yeah, I'm feeling back pain. I don't want to sit on the chair.
Okay, then you sit up. No problem. In general, it should be like that. No, if you have some problem, then you can sit up. That's okay. If you want to sit up. No problem. No problem. Seriously, you can sit down. So that's okay. That's no problem. Okay, and wash your feet before going to sleep. Previously they used to do. Wash your feet and dry it. You should not sleep with wet feet. And then feet is very important. Although we don't give importance. Vishnu stays in your feet. It is said, yeah. So Indra is hand, no? Sun and moon is eyes. Vishnu has taken charge of feet. So, it is said in Ayurveda, the more you wash your feet, people have regular habit of washing their feet. You have to keep your feet clean and keep on washing. It will increase your memory, increase your intelligence, increase your fire and everything. So previously, see, that is why you see, before eating food, you're washing feet. After eating food, washing feet. Before sleeping, you're washing feet. When you're getting up in the morning, first you wash feet. So that's a very good habit of washing your feet. At least before bed, you should wash your feet and dry it. And then sleep. Ideally. Okay, once you get up at night, don't sleep immediately again. Sometimes your sleep gets broken, no? And then you can go to sleep. No. Don't do that. If your sleep gets broken, get up, read something, chant something, 5-10 minutes, then again go to sleep. Don't sleep immediately. That is very important.
What happens?
You'll get dreams. Mm-hmm. And then your body will become more tired.
I do that. I sleep.
Then your body becomes more tired. Then you get up in the morning. Oh, what happened? So, once your sleep is broken, either you get up fully. Or if you want to sleep again, after 5-10 minutes, and sleep in between, do something. Chant Hare Krishna, do something. But don't immediately sleep. But if your sleep gets broken after 3:30, then you should not sleep again. Because according to Ayurveda, after 3:30 it's day. Day begins at 3:36. 3:36, our day begins. That's how it goes. So, according to prayer, that's another calculation. Sometimes day begins with sunrise for Ekadashi, after sunrise. But then sometimes it begins at 3:30. So if after 3:30 or 4 o'clock your sleep breaks, don't sleep again. Get up. Get up, do take your bath, do whatever. Then you can take rest afterwards, 40 minutes before going to office or whatever. But if your sleep gets broken at, suppose, 2 o'clock, 1 o'clock, then you get up for 15 minutes on the bed only. Do chant Hare Krishna, fingers, and then take rest.
You don't have to get up.
No, 1 o'clock. If your sleep breaks, then how? Then you, then you get up. Take, you can't do anything, no. Then when you feel sleepy, whole day. You see the point? So you sit on bed. Don't sleep immediately. Immediately, don't sleep. And then don't sleep. Okay, this I told you, never sleep from 10:30 to 2:30 and always sleep between 10:30 to 2:30 in the night. In the morning never sleep, in the night always sleep. 10:30 to 2:30, our body wants to go to sleep, and our body, you see, that time, 10:30 to 2:30 in the night, it is a time for creation, for metabolism, for producing things, keeping things in order. And in the afternoon, 10:30 to 2:30, that's a time for destruction. Catabolism. So it's time, it's breaking things. In the night, it's creating things. So you need to give sleep rest, body rest, so that it can create properly. In the afternoon, you don't need to give anything food, so that it destroys and it uses everything. If you give something, then it's a lot of catabolism and it ends up, you know. Okay, never sleep in dusk and dawn. That is important rule. Never sleep in dawn time and dusk time. You will become sick 100%. 100%. That's not the time for sleeping. Because at dusk there are ghosts.
Hey, I come from work 5 o'clock. So take a nap so I can...
At dusk...
Dusk is what time?
Evening. 4:30. No. See, time
after sunset. So
time I can't.
After sunset to dark is dusk.
When
so sun is already set, but it's still not. It's still like bright. It's
before,
not
before sunset is fine.
Yeah, of course. Before sunset is fine. Okay. So 5 o'clock, if you come and take some nap, that's okay.
Yeah.
But there's one rule, you know.
Google will give you time. What is dusk?
Yeah, dusk. It'll give you. So one thing is that when you're tired, never eat.
Never eat.
That's a rule. Never eat when you're tired. So generally, if you get tired, you come from office, okay, first eat. Don't do that. There's a tendency, no? I'm tired, let's eat and we'll become fresh. No. Because when you are tired, then you are eating, give food in the machine. First of all, body is tired and you are giving food. It will not be able to digest. There is no power to digest. So now when you are tired, get sleep first. And then eat. So when you come from office, just come from office, take a nap. Half an hour. Then get up and then eat something. That's how it should be ideally. If you are tired.
Eating is not a problem, sleeping, napping.
Yeah. So, but generally what you will do? You will eat and take a nap.
No, I just come home and sleep. And then wake up and do
everything else. Take half an hour. Yeah. 40 minutes. It's not dusk at 5 o'clock.
Yeah. Because some japa is left for 2 to 7. You take some break and become more fresh.
Okay, that time you can do. But if...
But not at dusk.
Then probably in winters it will be...
Yeah, that is the problem here, you know, they change the clock and, you know, then like in winter, you know, by 4 o'clock it's dark. Dusk has already happened at 3:30.
Push the time away now.
So you have to
Dusk has already happened. Yeah. Then,
dusk has already happened.
Then after dusk you can take rest, no?
But then we have to skip dinner in the winter.
Why?
Because it's already dark.
Yeah, you take before.
It's already dark, 3 o'clock.
I mean, like 5 will get dark in winter.
It will get dark, huh?
It will get fully
dark.
In that case, then you can take afterwards food.
That is, I mean, it's, at least Florida is better.
See, there is one rule also. When you are very hungry, then you can eat at any time. If you are extremely hungry. So what you have to do is, in that case, you have to make yourself very, keep yourself hungry. Extremely hungry. If it's dark by 5 o'clock, then you have to eat at 7 o'clock, no? But then at night you should not eat. So then what you should do is take morning 7 o'clock, 9 o'clock, don't eat anything in between. So you'll be like hungry like mad dog. Then you can eat at that time. So you'll not become sick. So you have to plan how to do. This little diligence is required. And then nothing happens. Just like Janmashtami, we take in night, no? Now it's 12 o'clock. But you are damn hungry. So it doesn't spoil your health. But if there's no hunger, less hunger, and then you take a night, then that's a problem. Because the point is, in night digestion is, you don't have digestion power, no? Our fire is linked to sun. Sun goes down, your fire goes down. So there's no fire. But when you're very hungry, there is fire. Your body produces fire. No, hunger means fire. So then your body can digest. But if you first of all don't have hunger, and then you take it at 7 o'clock, then there's a problem.
The program starts at 5.
Okay, I'm finishing now. I'm just done. I'm done now. Okay, do not sleep on your belly. Belly. Ulta. Don't sleep. That's the worst thing you can do. Yeah. Take appropriate sleep. Don't sleep less. Don't sleep more. That you have to.
Which side is good to sleep? Inside?
Side, any side, no problem. Okay, and conquer sleep by less sleeping. That's how you have to conquer sleep. Prabhupada says, if you want to conquer sleep, sleep less. Slowly you should practice sleeping less. So this is about sleep, and then I will tell other rules afterwards. About celibacy, there is one rule, Mithya Yog. You know what is Mithya Yog? That's called as, in Shastra it is said, don't allow your senses to come in contact with such things which will agitate your mind. So that is called Mithya Yog. Mithya means false, Yog means link. So some things will actually irritate your mind. For example, movies. That's Mithya Yog. Our body is not tuned to see something which goes so fast. The frames are changing, no? 1/8 second every frame is changing. Nature doesn't move like that. Nature is not like that. Nothing is moving at 1/8 second. Nothing changes. In fact, nature is slow. So that is Mithya Yog. Your senses are not made for that. But you're giving it that. So those movies, serials, everything, this will actually spoil your mind. spoil your health. Games. Video games. That's
driving.
driving. But anyway, that's okay, fine. But this media is very bad because your eyes are not made for that, and you're giving your eyes, so your mind gets disturbed. So that is called mithya yoga. You're giving something to the body. Which, what he is doing, Arunachalam?
Sunny.
Khichdi? What? You are making something, no?
No, he's making something. This is you.
No, no, but you are making something.
I already made it.
So then what you make, I'll take, we'll take that, no? You both made something?
No, that one is for the visit. I prepared.
Ah, okay.
No, they'll be eating, everyone is eating over there.
Okay, so this is the point, mithya yoga. Don't hear, see, you have to see. What your nature is. It's not natural, these things. So don't give something unnatural to these senses. Otherwise it's called mithya yoga. So that will agitate your mind and it will be very bad for health. So most of the modern technology is mithya yoga, no? It's most of it's mithya yoga. For like headphones, our ears are not accustomed to hear the sound which is coming from here. No. And directly it's coming here. So that's mithya yoga. Avoid all these things as much as possible. In modern age, you can't do much, but avoid it. So you'll be healthy. So these are the rules of ahar, nidra, and brahmacharya. You'll be healthy like that.
What time is good to wake up? That's what Pupisha is asking.
Wake up before sunrise. That's the best time. Before sunrise, you have to wake up before sunrise. Try that.
It's hard for her. See, children go to school, so she keeps sleeping until they wake up.
Oh.
Outside school, no?
When she's homeschooling, no? No, wake up before sunrise, then you can take a rest afterwards. See, you should do Mangal Arati in your house, by the way.
Yes, if Prabhu's help is there, then I can.